When wind blows in the atmosphere, air near the surface rubs against the Earth's surface. Friction then plays an important role in the balance of forces. As a result, there will be layers in between the lower air near the surface and the free atmosphere above. We are going to examine these boundary layers in rotating fluid, which is an analogue of layers in the atmosphere. These layers are known as the Ekman layers, named after a famous Swedish oceanographer. First, prepare a water tank with a circular insert. Fill the tank with water to a depth of about 10 cm. Make sure the water has a uniform temperature. Set the tank into rotation, say a speed of 5 revolutions per minute. Wait until the water is in solid body rotation. This may take 10 minutes or so. Then, sprinkle some potassium permanganate crystals at some distance from the center. As we have reached solid body rotation stage, the potassium permanganate should not have relative motion with the water. Potassium permanganate is soluble in water. The crystals will sink to the bottom of the water tank and slowly dissolve. We can then keep track on the water flow at the bottom layer. Paper dots are also added to reveal the surface flow. Now, slightly reduce the rotation rate to induce a lower pressure at the center and a higher pressure at the rim of the tank. Observe both the surface flow and the flow at the bottom. The experiment can be done in another way. If we increase the rotation rate instead, a high pressure would be induced at the center and a low pressure at the rim of the tank. And this is the result. Compare the two situations. By observing from above, we can see that the tracks of the paper dots and the potassium permanganate are different. It means that the flow at the surface and that at the bottom were not exactly the same. In both cases, the surface flow direction and the bottom layer flow direction made an angle with each other. In reality, there are two types of Ekman layers. One occurs at the surface of the ocean due to surface winds that drags on the surface of the ocean. Another type, which is demonstrated in this experiment, occurs at the bottom of the atmosphere and ocean due to frictional forces over rough surfaces. Let's regard our experimental setup as the atmosphere. Have a look at the balance of forces. High up in the free atmosphere, frictional force is small and therefore negligible. The pressure gradient force balances with the Coriolis force. The wind direction is along the isobars. However, when we get down to the Ekman layers of the atmosphere, friction becomes more and more important. The drag slows down wind speed. Coriolis force of the air mass is proportional to its speed, so Coriolis force becomes smaller as it slows down. As a result, the pressure gradient force wins. The flow will slightly bend towards the low pressure region. As frictional force keeps increasing down the atmosphere, the flow bends more and more. That's why the flow at lower layers and that at upper layers make an angle with each other. Our experiment demonstrates the phenomena in the northern hemisphere. Can you figure out the situation in the southern hemisphere?